I've removed the spark plugs. And let's discuss this gap here. See that gap? It's hard for me to show you with with my hands being taken up, but you can see a little space there. That space has to be a certain distance. And you use this little gizmo, a spark plug gapper tool, to measure the distance. You can see, hold on, let me put down the spark plug. See how it's tapered? Yeah, look at that. You figure out to what you're supposed to gap your spark plugs. 0.024. Oh, no, I think mine's supposed to be 0.028. Sorry, there's a bug crawling on my arm. And then you can gap your plugs to that. Let's see if I can do this with one hand. I'm guessing no. Men yelling. .024, .026, what is it supposed to be? Right in there. And this little end here, that bends. This little end right here. This little piece right there. There we go. Little top piece, a little. I'm trying to get it to focus. Black background's not helping. This little. Come on. There. This little end right here, this tab right here. This tab bends. And you want to make the distance from here. Right in here. This distance in here. This distance in here needs to be a certain amount. And it has to be spot on. It doesn't go any further. It won't go up any higher. 25, 24? 24? It should all be about that. If that's correct. On the end of the spark plug, there's this little oil retainer that stays in, that stays there. And you notice there's no part on the end of this. That does not go on with these spark plugs, spark plug cables. You need to remove that for these spark plug cables to attach properly.